Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part two of percent applications, and we are going to do these three problems on this video. So here's the first problem. Mary answered 72 out of 90 questions correctly on her math test. What percent did she answer correctly? All right, so the percent is always the amount over the base. So 72 out of 90 is actually 72 over 100. So we're looking for the percent. So I'm going to write P is what we're looking for, our percent. And she got 72 out of 90 correct. Now, this is very important to understand because this is how you can figure out your percent on any test. So now I could reduce this and then change it to a percent, or I can multiply by 100% and reduce all at once. It really doesn't matter which way you do it, but it's asking the percent she answered correctly. So your final answer should be written in terms of a percent. So I'm going to go ahead and go times 100%. Now it's true you can get out a calculator. You could do 7200 divided by 90 and get your answer, no problem, and figure it out. I am going to do this without a calculator. So I'm going to divide, see the 100 and the 90, I'm going to divide 10 into each of those, so then that just becomes 10, that becomes 9. And then 72 divided by 9 is 8. So basically, this just gives me 8 times 10%, right? Which is 80%. So this student answered 80% of the problems correctly. Here's our second problem. In a chemistry class of 56 students, 75% have had algebra. By the way, it's a really good idea to take algebra before you take chemistry. How many have had algebra? All right, so it's telling us there are 56 students total and 75% have had algebra. So that would just be 75% of the 56 students. Now, at this point, you need to change your percent to either a fraction or a decimal. So, if you wanted to do a decimal, you do 0.75 of 56, means you're going to multiply 56. And then you could either get out a piece of paper and do your multiplication, like on your scratch paper, and move your decimal two to the left, or you can get out a calculator to do that. The other way you can get this is to write 75% as a fraction, which is the way I like to do it. So 75%, just as a little reminder, as a fraction, is 75 hundredths. And then when you divide the top and bottom by 25, you get 3/4. So 75% as a fraction is 3/4. That's a common percentage, times 56. And I'm going to write this as 56 over 1. And I'm going to just get my answer without a calculator. So 4 goes into 56. Well, 2 goes into 56, 28, and then I just divide by 2 again. I'm going to get 14. And 3 times 14 is 42. If you get out a calculator and you do 0.75 times 56, you should also have gotten 42. So this means the answer is 42 students have had algebra. So the majority of the class has had algebra before taking chemistry, which is a good idea. All right, here's our next problem. After a holiday party, 35% of the employees called in sick the next day. That's a lot. That's like about a third, right? 28 employees called in sick. How many employees work at the company? All right, this is a little bit trickier. We don't know the total number of employees. That's what we're trying to figure out. But it's telling us that 35% of the employees, the total employees, is 28. Basically, that's what it's telling us, right? So in this case, what we don't know is this right here. which is the base. That means the total number of employees. So we can set this up as an equation if you want. 35%, we could write that as a fraction or as a decimal. I'm going to go ahead and write it as a decimal. 0.35 of means multiply. And the total, how about I use a T for the total number of employees, is equals 28. Now, this little time sign here confuses a lot of people, so I'm going to write that as 0.35 t. Because sometimes they think, oh, is that an x? No, it's not an x. All right, so now we've got 0.35 t equals 28. So how do I solve? I can just divide both sides by 0.35 and get a calculator out and get my answer. I'm going to try to do this without a calculator by rewriting 35% as a fraction. Okay, if you have a calculator, go ahead and do that. I have one, but I just like to see what it's like if I don't have a calculator as well. So here we go. Instead of 0.35, I'm going to change 35% to a fraction. So 35%, sorry. 35% means 35 hundredths, right? And then I'm just dividing the top and bottom by 5, 7/20. Okay. So I'm going to take my original problem here. 35% of the total is 28, but instead of writing 0.35, I'm going to write 7/20, okay? So we've got 7/20 times t, which I'm going to just write times t equals 28. Now, this does require that you know how to solve equations with fractions here, right? And all you need to do is multiply both sides by the reciprocal. So this 7/20, the reciprocal is 20/7. That way I'll be able to solve for t. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 20/7, and then I'm just going to cancel. 7 goes into 28, 4. Everything cancels over here. So I'm going to get my t is 80. All right, now I'm going to get out my calculator, see if I get the same thing. 28 divided by 0.35 is 80. Got the same answer. Now, why did I do that with fractions? Because I like to use my mind. I like to practice my arithmetic. Keep it up to date. All right, so let's go back up. What's the problem? After a holiday party, 35% of the employees called in sick. Okay, now let's see if this makes sense. 80 employees. So first of all, this is employees, is what we're looking for. 80 employees total, remember? That's what it wants to know. How many work at the company? So if you want, you could write 80 here as well, right? Okay. Does that make sense? If you had 80 employees and 35% called in sick, would that be 28? So it's a good idea to kind of check that out. What is 35% of 28? So in your calculator, do 0.35 times 80 and make sure you get 28. That's one way of checking. Another way to do it is to kind of approximate it. So 35% is about a third of 80. And then see, does 28, is that about a third of 80? Well, 28 is close to the number 30, right? And 80 is kind of close to the number 90. So it seems like it's in the ballpark. That's not checking it exactly. That's like seeing if it's in the ballpark. Like, 800 employees is way too much. Okay, so you can check by actually doing the 0.35 times 28. I'm sorry, 0.35 times 80 and making sure you get 28. That would be a way to check it to make sure. Or you could also ballpark it. So we've got our answer, 80 employees. I'm sorry, 80 employees work at the company. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.